This video is provided solely for illustrative purposes. The drills and techniques demonstrated in this video are not risk-free. No practice technique can completely eliminate the risk of injury. Dartmouth and Coach Stevens disclaim any liability arising from the use of the drills and techniques shared in this video.
I'm Buddy Tevens, the head football coach at Dartmouth College. In recent years, we've eliminated live tackling from all of our spring, preseason, and in-season practices. To ensure that our players are capable of tackling on game day, we've developed a series of drills with inanimate objects, pads, and a mobile tackling device. The end result was we actually tackled more proficiently, our missed tackle rate dropped by 50%, and we greatly reduced the injury rate to our players. Our defensive staff, Don Dobes, Sam McCorkle, and Dwayne Brooks, have done a tremendous job putting together drills that I think could be beneficial to people around the country. So we'd like to share these with you and wish you all the best as you develop your football team, preserve the health of your players, and spread the word about a different way to practice the game. Having reviewed extensive defensive tape, our staff has identified different contact points that occurred during the course of each tackle. Commonly referred to as the strike zone, we've separated these into three distinct areas: the high, the mid, and the lower level. There are also planes of contact that occur on each tackle. We describe them as the front, the side, and the back. We also discuss with our players vectors, or directional forces. We divide these forces into two groups: a pursuit approach, where a ball carrier is departing or escaping a potential tackler, and an attack approach, where the potential tackler is moving towards an oncoming ball carrier. The video that follows will provide examples of the types of drills we use daily in practice. Here at Dartmouth, our players never tackle or are tackled by a teammate in a live situation. We tackle extensively, just not each other. The result has been greater efficiency and effectiveness as tacklers and a safer practice environment for our players. Thank you for watching. I hope some of the instruction provided will prove beneficial to you and your coaching staff as you work to create the safest possible environment for your football program. All of us here at Dartmouth College appreciate what you do for the game and what you do for your players. Best wishes this fall.